TCN is in bad shape. the reality is in Berkshire. Why did I say that? Yes, we have a transmission capacity of 6,500, but TCN has problem with project management. Even by the World Bank study, a World Bank study was carried out, and it shows that TCN has a capacity to manage only 100 million projects per annum. And that would mean that TCN will not be able to expand its transmission capacity. That's what it means. So this 6,200 will continue to be 6,200, because if we are going to manage only 100 million projects per annum, it means that what we are going to be doing will only be rehabilitating the existing network. It will not be able to add any additional capacity. So what we are able to do is that we have reviewed the implementation capacity of TCN, and we have discovered what are the problems with TCN that made it not to deliver on its mandate. One of the problems we discovered is that there is no control and oversight by the management over project implementation, particularly donor-funded projects. We also discovered that the process of selecting key staff in implementing projects were not done through merit tests. We also discovered that the packaging of contracts were not done to attract the best all over the world. They are done to make Nigerian contractors get contracts. So we came up with a plan on how to organize the implementation capacity of TCN, and we discussed with the donors. And because they accepted the discussion that we have with them, we are able to immediately raise up to $1 billion for project implementation. Immediately, more than $1 billion, $1.1 billion. World Bank put in about $500 million. African Development Bank put $200 million. Islamic Development, $200 million. AFD, $200 million on grants. So we have about one, and then EU, $120 million. So we are able to raise that. We also discovered that there are projects that are on the pipeline, which was why I met with Amusun in January, was that this project has been a pipeline for almost since 2011, and this project has not been able to move from 2011. And the purpose of that project, which is $200 million, which is funded by JICA, that's why you see JICA and the city beside me here, is to solve the transmission constraint between Lagos and Ogun State. Because this area has increasingly become the industrial hub of Nigeria, and power is key to the expansion of the industrial hub. And some of those areas, their service will be at work at the transmission line. You know, if the industry is very big, we service them at the transmission capacity. We put 132 or 330 directly into that industry. So, but because of the fact that there is no transmission capacity, it's limiting the capacity to optimize what we are obtaining from this industrial hub around Lagos. And that's why JICA agreed to provide $200 million to put additional transmission capacity around these areas. So that is why I told the governor I was coming. Now, another project that was also on the pipeline that did not take off since 2011 is Abuja Transmission Project. That project also, since I came in 1 month, we were able to kickstart that project. We are even able to advertise the project is undergoing evaluation right now. Now, one of the things that we have succeeded, as I told you, we do is that even the package of the Abuja Transmission Project, we did it to attract the best in the world. We received a lot of complaints from Nigeria. Even Nigerian Society of Engineers wrote against me and copied the president. But we insisted that this time around we have to do things normally. And we have to not only try to satisfy the interests of individuals, but we should work towards the delivery of our infrastructure. And you know, transmission system, any transmission project, 30% of that transmission project is in civil work. And that means that even if you bring a foreign company, 30% of the project is civil work. It means that the local content is met. So this is why we are moving now. Now, in reviewing some of the problems we have to deliver on infrastructure, because this money that we are getting from the donors, including the ones that are not taken off, which is this one that we are talking about now, which is, if you add all of them, is close to about $1.5 billion. If we put this money, we are going to more than double the transmission capacity as it is now. It's going to be more than what it is now. But we cannot implement this project the way we have been implementing projects. if we want to do it the way we have been implementing the project, we cannot succeed. Because one of the key areas that I have been militating against implementation of projects is right of way and payment of compensation. And I discovered that if we are to succeed, we have to collaborate with this state, and some of those states have to take some of those responsibilities. As I told you earlier, my intention was to come to Ogun State before I go to other states. Unfortunately, it was not possible. Minister said he wants to come with me because this is his friend's territory, this is his area. So I was able to go to some other states. And I'm telling you, the collaboration I did with those states is 100% and very well, and it's working. For example, we collaborate with the Bauchi state governor. The land that we have been waiting for Bauchi to give for almost more than 15 years, we got it in 1 week. The environmental impact assessment and everything has been done. We have packaged the contract to put 330 kV, 2x150 MVA, and 2x60 MVA in Bauchi now under AAP project. We have packaged and we have completed everything. This is done in less than 1 month. If we are to do normal TCN way of doing things or normal way of doing things, we can't do this in 2 years. Kaduna also, we met with the governor of Kaduna and the governor of Kano. The line that took supply from Shiroro to Kaduna is only 600 megawatts. Because of the development that has taken place upstream that side, we have so many extensions that have been done on the lines. This line is heavily constrained. So we intended to build one of the biggest transmission lines in Nigeria. On that line, we want to build 2,400 megawatts. Now, if we want to do it very fast, the only way we can do is to reconstruct the existing land. And reconstructing the existing land means that all the houses that are under the right of way have to be taken out. And the only people that can do that is only the state government that can do it. We also need to build some additional substations in Kaduna. If you look at Kaduna, it's only one substation we have, transmission substation, which is Mandu. We told the governor we want 3 additional substations. One of them will be around the Millennium Park, which will be 330 MVA. Then around Igasa, we have 132 MVA. And then behind NAPC, we want to have another 132 MVA. We met the governor, we agree with the governor, and as I'm talking to you now, we have reached very, very far advanced stage because the governor has agreed with all the requests that we did to him, and he has deployed the state machinery behind us. Right now, the right of way, the survey, and everything is being done by Kaduna State Government, including the payment of compensation. They took it over, like just like Bauchi. They are doing it by themselves. The same thing, Kano. So right now, we are working to construct 2,400 megawatts from IG to, from Shiroro to Kaduna and then to Kano. And all this money are funded by Kaduna is funded by AAP. Kaduna to Kano is funded by Islamic Development Bank. So this is the way we are working. We have also met with the governor of Abia State and the governor of Imo State on the funding of Alauji to Onitsha transmission line. That line is also heavily constrained, and we have to build it to the tune of 2,400 megawatts also. The same thing we made with those governors. Those two governors have agreed. I have not gone back. We met with them in Abuja. I have not gone back to Abia to find out how far they have gone, but they have given the undertaking to remove all the obstacles around the right of way for us to construct the transmission line. The same thing I made with the governor of Delta State. He's also working to remove all the encumbrance between Delta and Benin to allow us to reconstruct that line to 2,400 megawatts also. So this is the way we are working, and it's a leading result, honestly. But my intention is actually to come to Ogun first. But I've told you the reason. Now, this project that we're talking about now is 200 megawatts and $200 million financed by JICA, which has been on the drawing board since 2011. What we have done since I came in is that we have succeeded in recruiting the consultant. The consultants are 3 of them, because the project is divided into 3. They are here with us. We have signed an agreement with them to start the environmental and social assessment and to prepare the ramp to assess the need for compensation and the rest. They are here with us. So we want to launch the project and work with you. Because if we said that TCN is going to do this project alone, I don't think this project is going to take off. You know why? By our estimate, if TCN is going to do the work, it means that TCN is going to spend about $30 million to pay for compensation. I don't think we'll have that money. So that is why we are collaborating with you. And this project is between Ogun and Lagos. But about out of the 6 substations that we are building, only one is in Lagos. All the rest of them are in Ogun State. You know, now it's difficult for somebody to separate between Ogun and Lagos. I think you are the people that are already with you that are from here. But this is how we have come to meet with His Excellency to explain to you and to seek his support. So the minister and him can talk later, maybe through their political channel. But from the practical side, we have come to meet him and explain to him and to seek his support and see how we can collaborate to deliver this project the way we are delivering for the other section of Nigeria. Thank you. This is the nutshell.
Thank you very much, MDTCN, for that speech. Right now, let me invite the consultant.
I have the special advisor and the general manager of the State Housing Corporation, which I strongly believe has the purview of virtually most of the places that the transmission line is going to go through. So he's here with us. And I have Nick, his special advisor, his excellency of power.
Something in a lot of time, which I will be a possibility.
shelter from actually doing party that is going on. I think we can have a solution to something that can really provide opportunity of for our people here. But not knowing that we are going to work for this vision. So what we are going to ask for, because it's something that we can look at the details of what we require and what we need. So we will be able to advise him and we will be able to give us what where he can assist us and what we are not able to do for us. We are willing and I will refer this meeting to be able to have details. Yes, thank you. You have given us a broad view of what we just designed. So we want to see in as mission that we want to establish a life of way of it. Yes, what the state can do for you, we will be able to be sure, you can rest assured that we will provide you an enabling environment. We will provide, the state will provide you an enabling environment to make sure this thing is achieved. So we want to see the details, and if we can look at the details, we take notes, and I'm sure this person is going to see you before you leave. You cannot give a details proof of today, definitely in the next 1 week or two. We will never believe this issue. All we require from you is the details of what you want us to do. The expanse of land that is going to take place will cover. Then we see caution. So we need to understand the experts. We bring all our technical people. We will see. And then because what we can do for you, we will give you, we are going to have an open ended meeting with you. We are going to tell you specifically between now and 2 weeks, you will get this information from us. Between now and another week, you will get this information from us. But you can be rest assured, as soon as we have the details of your design and drawing, to be able to tell you to bring up the land, because as a corporation, I think, as far as we believe, when it comes to it, they have the experience now as a corporation. So I'm sure they will be able to advise what they can do for us. The Sessiles wants us to discuss the details and advise him. So let's do that and then we can advise him. You are not able to say the volumes. So I want to raise this issue. And let's have the details of what we are going to do. I will be able to let you know what we are going to do before you get to.
Thank you, Robert. I think there are some things that are not highlighted. All these capacities we are putting, we call the distribution companies, all of them, and we discuss with them that look, TCN, we have money here. Where are the capacities? Where are the areas that you want capacity? And they told us, and we prepare the project in that line. Even the generation company, you ask them, you want additional capacity that will require TCN to also expand its capacity, they tell us. And we did it. Now, we didn't stop at that place, at that point. We did what the board wanted. You know, we have a system planning unit. We made it, modeled the project and the existing capacity to 3 KB. What does that mean? We came out with the need of investment by the distribution companies. That this is what you need to do. These are the investment requirements on your side. Because if TCL put all the capacity that we can put, Nigeria will not get electricity. If the distribution companies cannot meet the laws, they can't. Maybe only those customers that are starting on 330 and 132 and 330 KB. All others will not get supply. So we model up to their level to say this is the amount of capacities that you need to put. And we costed it. And the preliminary figures we share in the electricity, Nigeria Electricity Distribution, Nigeria Electricity Commission, Nigeria Regulatory Commission. And that formed the reason why, look at the last power sector stakeholders forum, NAC made a pronouncement that the distribution company have to capitalize. They have to capitalize. Because it's not something that they can even fund it from their revenue now. They have to capitalize. Just like TCN is being capitalized now. So this is the revolution that we are bringing in the industry. So we are going to stop at that level now. We are hiring a consultant to validate the simulation that we have done so that there will be no argument from any side before we write a format and say this is it. So we are expecting that the government is likely going to come the way they have done with Central Bank something like that is likely going to come up for the distribution companies for them to be able to speak the law. But I also want to tell you that when you say that we should tell you what are the specific requirements, we don't have any specific requirements, and that's why we want to collaborate with you. All the consultants that we hire that are going to work to do the review and do the study to establish what is the compensation, what is the... They are here. We recruited them, but we never launched the project. We said we are going to launch the project when we meet with Ogun State. So we are going to expect Ogun State is going to give us a team that are going to work with them. But what I can tell you that has happened in the past is that when TCN says they want to pay compensation, the price goes very high. When the state takes over those responsibilities, the money drops significantly. You know? Because the state are the owner of land, they know who they have allocated land to, they know who is who. We, they see us as an outsider, the money increases significantly. But there's a place where they say there's compensation, we have to pay compensation. Immediately the state took over the owner of land, they say zero compensation now. No compensation in that place. No single combo of state. So this is what I'm just going to tell you. But I cannot tell you that this is the requirement. But let me tell you the areas that we are going to put capacity. The areas that we are going to put capacity are, there's a place they call Likosi, which is Yes. At that place, we are putting 330-132 substation. 132 substation. This is our highest voltage in the city, yes. Then,
at Lucas.
Yes. So we are going to require you to help us give us that substation where we are going to put. We will need the right of CFO of that place to be given to us. And so this is that's the place. Then the second place, the second one we are going to put substation is near Redeem. Redeem Church of God.
Near Redeem.
Redeem Church of God, yes.
In
Chicago. Yeah, I think we are around that, yes. Near Redeem Church of God. There's a place that is identified. It's not inside the Redeem per se, it belongs to one community around that place. So that is that place. That one would be 132 substation.
132.
Yeah, yes. Then we have a place, we are looking for a place near Mountain of Fire.
Okay.
See, the problem we have is that some of our staff have discussed with Mountain of Fire. They have actually agreed that they are going to give land inside the Mountain of Fire. But I told them this is not the right approach to do, because if you discuss Babani, you have not discussed anything. Because they don't have any document to show that the Mountain of Fire is giving this for
them. Substation.
So we need, around that Mountain of Fire, we need the Ogun State government to give us a land that we can put 330-132.
132
substation also. There is a land that you gave us before, but that land is not suitable. It is full of machinery. In fact, the cost of filling that place will cost more than the cost of fixing the substation.
Yeah. Where is this? You know this Chinese company along the Lagos
after
Ceramics. Yeah, it's close to that place.
So I went to tell the minister that I'm going to Ogun State. He said, no, you cannot go, we have to go together with you. Unfortunately, because of significant engagement of the minister, so many things, we are not able to pin down when we should come. So yesterday, we went to inaugurate the Rural Electrification Agency. So after the inauguration, I met him. I went to his office and said, Mr. Minister, you know this thing, we have wasted so much time. So tell me when we are going to Ogun State. say, okay, if that's the case, you should go alone. So he immediately called His Excellency and he agreed that I should come immediately. And I mobilized my team. That is when I came. Your Excellency, I want to tell you that since I came in at the end of TCN, it has not been very easy. And to be honest, if I had known the problem of TCN is that big the way it is, I wouldn't have come. Listen, I wouldn't have come. Because the problem is very, very, very serious. Before I came in, I was thinking the problem is the problem of staff of TCN and TCN. But when I came in, I discovered that the external factor is even more serious than the factor of TCN. Recall that TCN was being managed by Manitoba Hydro. Manitoba Hydro is a company of Canada. So TCN is highly top heavy now. When I was there before, we did several studies to prepare TCN for management, private management, private management. One of the studies we did was the change management consultancy that was done by the in 2005. At that time, it was determined that TCM was top heavy, meaning they have too many management staff. And TCM had aging workforce. And TCM has too many non-technical staff. So that study was done, was supposed to be implemented by Manitoba Hydro. Manitoba Hydro was not even given the report and they never implemented it. At that time, TCM is called Transisco, Transmission and System Operation Company. It's under the management of PSN. So they don't have MD, but they have executive director, two of them. So at that time, TCN has 10 general managers. And that is 7 in outside and 3 in the headquarters. TCN had 11 assigned general managers. So when I took over TCN now, TCN has, even at that time, say it's top heavy, sir. But TCN has 46 general managers now, with 134 assigned general managers instead of 11. This is the kind of company that we have inherited. And you know, collapsing and spoiling an environment is easier. But to make it work is very difficult. You have so many general managers in TCN that TCN general manager has become something like a useless thing, honestly. So these are the kind of tasks that we are managing. I have also come to discover that procurement in TCN is not done with anything of value for money. Procurement is done in such a way to eliminate people they want to eliminate and give people they want to give. The first tender board that I chaired in TCN when I came here, I took a decision to remove the general manager of procurement immediately. And I had to remove her immediately. And I said, let me give to the second person next to him, and I give the assignment that the general manager did to the second person. I said, evaluate and give me. And I gave him the requirement of evaluation. Thank God that these are areas that I'm very, very conversant with. I gave the person and said, this is the way to do things. When you are evaluating for whose, you don't go for scoring. What you do preliminary evaluation. Then after you do preliminary evaluation, which will help you to determine compliance with the kit. Then the next thing you go for substantive evaluation, which you are going to look for capacity, experience. And once you establish the capacity and experience and compliance with the specification, the next thing, price determine who wins. I explained to this man like this. The man went and did the evaluation and come with the same method the previous person did. So I have no option but to look inside TCN and bring anybody that I think has experience to become the general manager. And I did it. So we have been navigating like that, sir, very difficult. But one thing that we have succeeded in doing in the last few months, sir, is that we have succeeded in proving to donors, international donors, that we have capacity to deliver. Previously, before I came, there's a study that was conducted by World Bank, which indicated TCN had capacity to implement only 100 projects, $100 million project per annum. Meaning TCN cannot be able to expand its capacity, that's what it means. So we reviewed the process of implementation of project and we discovered 3 key factors that have been militating against implementation of project. One of the factors is that there is no oversight over donor funded projects. They say World Bank project, that's all. No, the TCN management have no oversight over it. So they don't know what they're doing, so they leave them to do whatever they want to do. The second problem is that in the selection of the key implementation staff, merit is not taken into consideration. So they just put people they want to put there, and there's no merit. The third thing that we discovered, is the packaging of contracts and implementation of contracts. So you will see one person supervising project in TCN. One project is in Ogun State, one is in Sokoto State, one is in Kogoro State. When somebody headquarters is supervising this project. When we have transmission project in presence in Lagos, we have general manager transmission in Oshogbo, we have general manager transmission in Shiroro. So this is how it's done. We have organized this and said, first of all projects are going to be implemented from the region. And that's why you see the Lagos general manager is here. If it is before, he doesn't have to be here. They will be doing everything from headquarters. But it's not, we have changed the process. We say all projects are going to be implemented at the region. And that is what we are doing now. So we have solved those problems and we have presented to the donors. And I can tell you, sir, instantly, we raised $1.1 billion, something that has never happened in the history of TCN. And not only that, we agree with the international donors that we are going for what is called advanced procurement. So even before we conclude the process of the loan, we start the procurement process. Right now, Lagos Region, for the component of the World Bank, Lagos Region, we are advertising them next week, $104 million. We are fixing all the control rooms. We are upgrading all the substations in Lagos. We are also doing some reconducting in the Lagos region. And also, we are advertising the one of Kaduna region also, at the same time with the Lagos region, immediately. That's what we are doing. This project has not been signed into agreement, sir, but we are going ahead with the procurement. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So this is the way we are going, sir. The way we are going also, sir, is that we discovered that we cannot succeed in expanding the transmission capacity the way we want it without collaboration with the states. So we, you know, I told you I wanted to come here first, but Minister prevented me. But I've collaborated with some states, sir. And the experience that we have got with that even give us more need for us to collaborate with the states. States that places where we are finding it difficult to get right of circular occupancy. We went to the 1 week. For example, in Kaduna and Bauchi, we got them in 1 week. Things that have not happened in maybe 10 years, 15 years ago. We have also collaborated with some states, particularly Kaduna and Kano, and we discovered that where they ask for compensation to be paid, when we are convinced the state to take over the issue of compensation, they came and they said there's zero compensation. So meaning, if it is us, the price go up, but if it is the state, those price doesn't go up. And that is why I went to the minister. I said, look, we have, under this time when I came also, we have succeeded in recruiting the consultant to do the study for the JICA project, which is funded by JICA. That's why the representative of JICA is here with me, sir. This project would put in transmission capacity of Ogun State only. We are putting at what 330, we are putting 330 kV, we are putting 1,200 gigawatts, which is equivalent to 960, that is 1,200 megawatt hour, that is MVA, which is equivalent to 960 megawatts. 960 megawatts at 330. We are putting at 132, we are putting 600. Yeah?
100%.
Yes, yes. At 132, we are putting 680 megawatt hour, which will translate to 544 megawatt in terms of megawatt of electricity. So this is what we are doing. This is very key, sir. If you look at the total transmission capacity of Nigeria right now, it's 6,500. If we are putting in one state 544 in one project, we have never done that kind of extension in one place at one time. And that's why this is very key to whatever we are doing. And you know, once we put this one, you know, I told you the capacity at 330 is 9,600. It means that if there is need for us to add additional capacity at 130, we just put additional transformer. We don't need to extend line. We just put additional transformer. So this gives flexibility and gives room for growth in this area. So those places we are going to transmission substation that we mark for the expenditures, these are the places, sir. One of them is Likosi. I think it's between Ikorodu and Shagamu. Between Ikorodu and Shagamu, we are putting 132 substations. So we are going to put 2 by 150 MPA in that place, and we are going to put 2 by 60 MPA at 132. Another place is that there is a location that we are identifying near the Redeem Church. That place also we are putting 132 substation. And then at a place very close to Mountain of Fire, no, around Mountain of Fire place, because there was a discussion between my colleagues before I came in, that Mountain of Fire is willing to see the them land to build the substation inside Mountain of Fire. But sir, I told them to give me the document that shows that the Mountain of Fire has agreed. They couldn't give me any document. So I said I don't want to believe this kind of discussion, because anything that is verbal discussion is not a discussion. So I think it's better for me to plead with the state to see where we can get the land around that place, so that we can decide the 330-132 substation close to the Mountain of Fire. Then we have a place they call Ajebule, which is very close to Agbara. That place also we are putting 330-132 substation. And there's a place they call Aribajo, I think Ijeo, around that place. I think that place is even going to be the hub, because that is the place where the main substation is going to be. So all the other substations will be there from that place. Sir, here is my team, sir. We have the general manager Lagos, we have the representative of JICA, we have all the people that are involved, supposed to be involved in the study, because we have to do the study before we start the construction of the substation. And so also on the federal side, we have also agreed to meet with the Minister of Environment. We are going to extract some commitment from them, because we have to get some waivers of the timeline of all these deliveries, so that we reduce certain the time so that we can be able to deliver. But we have the two consultants that have been recruited to do this study are also here. Let me three. The intention side is for us to launch the project with the state as a stakeholder in this project. And for the state to be part of us, so we will have our team and your team. Our team represented by the consultant and our people that are working with them, and your team to work on this project. The same way we are working with Kaduna, Governor of Kaduna, which Honorable Minister even told me yesterday. In fact, one of Kaduna's, I want to tell you that we didn't even hire the consultant, it's Kaduna that hired the consultant and their money, and they are the one paying the compensation. Even the right of way is the Kaduna Geographical Information System Department that is doing it. But for the Ogun State, we have already gone hired the consultant, so we can work with you. This is why we come here, sir. So, but another thing I want to tell you, sir, is that we are also pushing for revolution in the power sector. If we put all this capacity, this $1.1 billion that I told you are getting from donor agencies, include $500 million from World Bank, which we have gone very far, $200 million from African Development Bank, $200 million from Islamic Development Bank, $200 million from JICA, from AID. We have projects that have been on drawing board, which has not kicked off since 2011, which is this JICA project for projects and the JICA AP project for Abuja Transmission Project. So the Abuja Transmission Project has been on the drawing board just like this project since 2011. So I want to tell you that I've advertised that project. I've advertised it. We are doing the evaluation now. We are going ahead. So, sir, what I want to tell you is that all those projects that we are doing, if we put them, they will not give electricity to Nigerians. We are even doing SCADA. SCADA has not been very well. We are executing the one project, we are doing the SCADA. Then we are digitalizing all the control rooms in Nigeria. But Nigeria will not have electricity as it's supposed to. Only those that are serving a transmission interface that will get electricity, meaning big industries. and the ordinary people will not get electricity. So that is why we reduced stuff at that level. We cleverly decided that in preparing this project, sir. So if I tell you all weekends I come to, there's no weekend at any, don't come to me. Sometimes I close 10 o'clock. Yesterday, yesterday I came back from a new place. And yesterday I came to go instead. This is the way we are doing this. But if we put all those capacities, we are not going to get, Nigerian people will not get notice. So we didn't stop at that level. We cleverly discovered all the distribution companies, including all the infrastructure. We tell them, where do you want additional capacity? Where do you need flexibility? They tell us. We discovered all the generation companies in Nigeria that what are your plans to generate more electricity? They tell us. And we now factor it in the calculation of all the transmission projects we are doing. Now, when we did that, when we finished that one, sir, we modeled the investment up to that figure. Meaning, we modeled to show if we put this capacity in all those places, what is the investment requirement on the side of distribution to pick the load? This is what we did. When we modeled and quantified the quantity of this, we now forwarded the preliminary report to NAC. That explains the reason why we listened recently, sir. NAC is saying distribution company have to capitalize. Because they know something they can source from their level. TCN is being capitalized now through this money that government is getting from them. Distribution companies also have to capitalize. If they don't capitalize, we will not get. And from the body language of the Nigeria Electricity Commission as it is now, and the support that the minister is giving, because he himself is also interested in delivery. And sir, I want to tell you, sir, because he is your friend. To be honest, I've taken several decisions that would have been controversial. We have removed so many people. So many of them will say, I favor Yoruba, tomorrow they say, I favor Hausa, next tomorrow, because I've removed so many people. I have to change people who are not. And we have to collapse the system, we have to make the system to work. Sir, with that decision, several people have challenged me, but the minister has always stand by me, honestly. He has never sugarcoated. Anyway, he was one who brought me, so he has to support me to succeed. We have also cancelled some contracts that we think are not reasonable. Some of them have challenged us after the office of the president, sir, and we have refused to patch, to be honest. Even when we package Abuja transmission project, we package it to attract the best all over the world. Up to the level of the Nigerian Society of Engineers, the president wrote against me, the president of Nigeria, the minister stand by me, we never listened to them. So this is something that is also sharing news. Though, as I told you, if I thought the problem was that big, I wouldn't have come. But with the support of the minister, we are able to do so many things, and I think it's also an interest to make sure that to do what is right and deliver for the interests of our people. Sir, this is the area that I want to talk to you. But sir, there's also a few things. There's one substation in your state, which is called Agbara. These people, they are the ones that invite TCN when they are building this estate, that TCN should come and put a substation in that place so that they can get the quality supply. TCN agreed to come, they gave the land to TCN, TCN agreed. The mistake that our people did at that time was not to formalize, because estates cannot give their land, it's government that gives land. So they should have gone to get the states to give them right of occupancy on that land. They didn't do that. Now this land, this estate, now after they have got the infrastructure, their place has become good, they have got a quality supply, they are now writing that TCN had to pay them 960 million naira for compensation for their land, that we have to buy the land for them now, after they are the one that gave it willingly that time. So the danger is that there are even some people in TCN who are even ready to say, well, let's talk to them. But it's dangerous. Well, if we pay that money, it means that all over the country we are going to get that kind of problem. Everybody is going to ask. So we want the state government to help us solve that problem. Because if the state government gives us right occupancy of that place, just like they give the right of occupancy to the Agbara estate, that problem is solved. Nobody would challenge that people to say we have to pay for that land. So, Your Excellency, I'm grateful, sir. Thank you for your audience and your time.
Well, I don't think I need to waste your time, rather than to say that you know the importance of the words you are doing, and we're talking to you, just like you said. The next year is the
activity as a hotel. Yes, it's true. So we met at his concert. He told me to go to TCN. Well done that you are there. Well done that you know what you are doing. Let me just ask that we are Nigerians, that we should have that spirit. It's going to be there, we shouldn't be there. How do I put it? I don't want your spirit to be down. You should just be ready for the assignment. It's not. Maybe if you are going to do it right and get it right, it's going to be your health, very tough. So you shouldn't be on that issue. It's going to be just a tea party. That is when you are, and it is when you are ready. That's why people will say that love time to masses is not going to that you will be ultimately by all. So you will still encounter many challenges as you overcome. Yes. And sometimes the time people will get to realize that this is the way it should be. And so before the night, it will be tough when you get like this. So happy with what you are doing. People don't know. Children and precious times when maybe our examples, even if they are able to go to whatever level that they want them to be, we will discover that we cannot even translate it on the top of the institution. So it's a very key assignment that you are doing. We will support you as government, and I will do it.
Once again, welcome to the States. sir.
Even the government is in their interest, it's even in the interest of government of Bahrain, so that they can say this is what they are doing, and some from the power sector. So it is my interest to come to them. So when they give their timeline on how to do, the team will, if they have it today, they can do it. If they don't have it, we give them time when they don't have it, then you review it. And once you review it, you give the consent team have to agree the timeline we are agreed on. Then it is there, we call it to you and tell you this is the timeline that we have agreed. And that's what we're going to do to them, is it? So this is how it is. But you know, there's also responsibility on the other side. That's where I was asking you this question. Where is the money coming from? Because that also is happening that the consultant, immediately they submit their report, we have to pay them whatever that is in line with the contract. That's how it is. And on our side, we make sure that we fix whatever problem we have. So any other question?
So
are
you going now or can we
fix
next week?
Where no,
we
should do the meeting
no,
today. No, no, you can do the meeting.
We can do the meeting. I have to get, I mean, because mostly I need the lamps.
Yeah, what I will do, the governor has already given the directive.
I'm going to.
Sorry, so what I would suggest is that I think you and Comfort and you will stay in combat here. Sit down and launch this project. Sit down and agree with them, you know, the state who is working with just conductor. You understand what I'm saying? And let me know the contact of the person, the teacher of land, the consent, and also the family to them, the teacher of the city of work, all the land.
The right of work.
The right of work. So you should do this before you come back.